Hello everyone, I would like to welcome all of you to Mahdi English School. As you all know that right now we are in class of standard 1. Right now we are learning subject maths. Who am I? I am your maths teacher. So, how are you all my dear students? I hope you all are fine and safe at your home. We will start our class with a very beautiful thought. Thought for the day is, you cannot change your future, but you can change your habits. Surely, your habits will change your future. What is the thought? You cannot change your future, but you can change your habits. Surely, your habits will change your future. Welcome to the world of maths. What we are going to learn today in maths? Learning objectives for today, as you all know that right now we are making revision. In this today we will make revision of chapter number 3, subtraction. First of all, we learn introduction of subtraction. Then simple subtraction. After that, as I told you in previous lecture, today we will learn table of 5. What is subtraction? In maths, to subtract means to take away from a group or a number of things. What should we do? Subtraction means to take away from a group or number of things. When we subtract, the number of things in the group reduce or become less. You can understand that if we are going to take away something from a group or number of things, there will stand some things which are less in numbers, or it reduces. Okay, in the subtraction problem, 7 minus 3 is equal to 4. The number 7 is the minute, the number 3 is the subtrend, and the number 4 is the difference. What is the answer called in subtraction? It is called a difference between these two numbers. Okay, subtract and write the answer in the box provided. Cross out to given number of objects to find the answer. What should we do? We should cross out the number of given objects and then we have to write. So look, how many objects are these? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 and 14. We have to subtract how many numbers? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. So we have to cross out 8 out of these 14 flowers. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Let's see how many remaining. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Okay? Understand? How many watermelons are there? 1, 2 and 3 slices are here. How many we have to cut down? 1 and 2. Now look what happens. We have to cross out 2 as we have to cut 2 slices among these 3. 1 and 2. Now see how many slices are remaining there. It is 1. So we have to write it in the given box. Okay. How many honeybees are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There are 6 honeybees. Out of that we have to cut 1, 2 and 3 honeybees. Okay. How many honeybees should we cut? 3. Okay. Now we have to cross out 3 honeybees out of this group of 6 honeybees. Look. 1, 2, 3. How many remaining honeybees are there? 1, 2 and 3. So we have to write it in the given box. We can say that this is the difference between these two groups. Okay. Now look, what is this? These are 5 red color balls. What we have to do? We have to cross out 3. Among this group of 5 circles, we have to cut 3. 1, 2 and 3. How many circles are remaining there? There remains 2 circles, which we have to write it in this box. Now, this is the sum 7 minus 6. Look, these are 7 circles. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. What we have to do now? We have to cut or reduce 6 out of them. Let's do it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now, if we want to find out the difference between these two group of numbers, what should we do? We should count the remaining object, which is 1. And it is the difference between these two group of numbers, which we have to write here. Okay, so we can say that difference between 7 and 6 is 1, or 7 minus 6 is equal to 1. We can read this sum as 7 minus 6 is equal to 1. Now look, how many objects are there? There are 4 objects. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Our sum is 4 minus 2. So we have to cut or reduce 2 objects among given 4 objects. Let's do it. 1 and 2. See how many objects are remaining there, my dear? There remains 2 objects. 1 and 2. So we should write it in the answer box. Okay? Understand? Is the topic clear to you? Let's see more examples. Look, how many objects are there? There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 objects. And we have to cut 1 among these given objects. Okay? So, if we want to find out the difference between these two objects, what should we do? We should count the remaining objects. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. 6 minus 1, we get number 5. 6 minus 1, we get number 5. Okay. Now, our sum is 9 minus 5. So, what should we do? First of all, we should cut the 5 objects among this given 9 objects. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, now, what do you say? What should we do? Should I write this side of object? Should I count this one? Or should I count this one? What do you say? We should count the remaining objects. Keep this thing in your mind while doing subtraction sums, my dear. We should count this side, the remaining objects, which is 1, 2, 3 and 4. Okay? Count and subtract. How many dots are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Out of 8, I have to cut these 3 dots. Then how many dots are remaining there? 1, 2 and 3. By cutting 3 dots from 8 dots, I will get 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 dots. So difference of 8 and 3 is 5. Now look, how many dots are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So out of 7 dots, I have to cut this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 dots. Then how many dots will remaining there? Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. I have to reduce this 6. So how many dots will remains there? 1 dot, which I should write in the answer box. 7 minus 6, I get number 1. Now look, count with me, how many dots are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Out of that, I have to reduce 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. By reducing 8 from number 11, I will get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. I have to reduce these 8 dots. Now see how many dots are remaining there. These 3 dots, 1, 2 and 3, which we should write in the answer box. Okay? Next is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. I have 8 dots here. Out of that, I have to cut 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So, I have to reduce 7 from number 8. So, how many numbers will remains there? See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. If I am going to reduce this 7 from the 8, there will remain 1 dot only, which we can write it in the box. Oh, how many dots are this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Why am I counting this? So that you can understand you and you have to count with me, okay? 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and 12. These are 12 dots. Out of that, I have to cut 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. If I am going to reduce 10 from this 12, how many dots remaining? 1, 2, 3 and 4, 5 and 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Should I stop? Yes, I should. Now see how many dots are remaining there. 1 and 2, which I should write it here. Okay, let's see some more examples. As you can see that these are also 12 dots. Okay, out of 12, how many dots should I cut? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Out of 12, I have to reduce this 8 dots. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Look, I have to stop here. And I have to count the remaining dots. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Okay? Understand? Look. What is this? Subtraction with cubes. In each case, subtract and write the correct number of objects. In each case, subtract and write the correct number of objects. Look, what is the sum? The sum is 6 minus 2. The sum is 6 minus 2. Look at the picture. How many objects are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Out of that, look, how many objects we have to cut? 2 objects, 1 and 2. Now, how many objects are remaining there? We have to count these remaining objects. 1, 2, 3, 4, which we have to write it here. How many objects are these? These are 2 objects. And what is the sum? 2 minus 2. Our sum is 2 minus 2. So I have to cut all the 2 objects. And how many objects are remaining there? Is there any object remaining? No. So what should I write here? If I want to minus 2 from 2, what I will get? What is the difference? The difference is 0. Okay? The sum is 7 minus 4. Look how many objects are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. There are 7 objects. Out of that we have to cut 4 objects. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now what should I do? I should count the remaining objects. See, how many objects are remaining there? Count with me. 1, 2 and 3. So I have to write these 3 objects here. Now, look at here. How many objects are there? The sum is 8 minus 5. So, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8 objects. Out of that, I have to cut or reduce these 5 objects. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now what should I do? I should count these remaining objects. 1, 2 and 3. Okay? What is the sum? The sum is 6 minus 5. We have how many objects? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now what should I do? I should cut or reduce these 5 objects from the given 6 objects. Look, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. How many objects are remaining there? 1. 6 minus 5. The difference is 1. Okay? Next sum is 5 minus 3. There are 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 objects. There are 5 objects. Out of that, I have to cut 3 objects or I have to reduce 3 objects. 1, 2 and 3. How many objects are remaining there? 1 and 2. The sum is 7 minus 3. The sum is 7 minus 3. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7 objects. How many objects I have? I have 7 objects. Out of that, I have to cut this 3 objects. 1, 2 and 3. So how many objects are remaining there? See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 7 minus 3, the difference is 4. The sum is 8 minus 2. The sum is 8 minus 2 means I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8 objects. There are 8 objects. Out of that I have to cut or reduce these 2 objects, 1 and 2. Now what should we do? Do you remember? Should I write these blocks here or I have to write the number of these objects here? What do you say? What should I do? So, we should write the remaining objects as we are doing subtraction right now. Okay? Let's count with me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Subtract the following. 7 minus 1. So we can say that how many objects are here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Out of that I have to reduce 1 as our sum is 7 minus 1. Okay? Now if I want to know the difference, I have to count this remaining objects. Let's count it with me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We have 6 objects remaining. So we should write it in the given box. Now look. What is the sum? The sum is 5 minus 4. The sum is 5 minus 4. Look how many objects are there. There are 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 objects present. Whenever we are going to make subtraction, we have to reduce or cross out the number of objects which we have to cut down, which is 4. So we have to cut this 1, 2, 3 and 4 objects out of given 5 objects. Okay? And how can we get the answer? If we want to know the answer or difference, we have to count these remaining objects. How many objects are remaining here? 1. So 5 minus 4 is 1. What is the sum? 6 minus 5. What is the sum? 6 minus 5. Look, how many objects are here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. There are 6 objects. Out of that, we have to reduce 5 objects. Okay? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Now see how many objects are remaining there? 1. So 6 minus 5, we get 1. What is the sum? 6 minus 4. Look how many objects are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We have 6 objects. Out of that, we have to cut 4 objects. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, if I want to know the difference, I have to count these remaining objects. Look how many objects are remaining there. 1 and 2. There are 2 objects remaining. Let's write it here. So, do you understand how to make subtraction? Huh? Today we have understand how to make subtraction with different objects and different examples. Till now, we have learned table number, table of 1, table of 2, table of 3 and table of 4. Now, we are going to start table of 5. Are you all ready, my dear students? Shall we start the table of 5? You all have to repeat the tables after me. Okay. Are you ready? Table of 5. 5 ones are 5. 5 twos are 10. 5 threes are 15. 5 fours are 20. 5 fives are 25. 5 sixes are 30. 5 sevens are 35. 5 eights are 40. 5 nines are 45. 5 tens are 50. So, my dear student, this was a table of 5. Now what you have to do, you have to make practice of all the tables, not only table of 5. Okay? Till now, we have learnt tables from 1 to 4. And now, we have introduced table of 5. So, you have to make practice of all these tables at your home with the help of your parents. Till now, stay safe, stay happy. Take care of yourself. Don't trouble your mother, my dear students. Make practice every day of each and every subject. Okay? Bye-bye.